Hey, welcome back to Ask Allison. Here is today's question. Okay, I'm looking for support, backup, ideas. How do you set boundaries around your availability outside of appointments or lack thereof? I offer courtesy calls back in emergencies as I'm available, but I found that some clients will take advantage of this and or it sets them up for feelings of anger and abandonment when I'm not available. So far, I've reliably predicted who will abuse this courtesy and who will use it appropriately. I'm considering a blanket policy stating that I'm not available outside of appointments, but then this may be unsupportive to clients who can benefit and use appropriately. How do you handle this? So I'd like to thank Therapy Notes for sponsoring us. I am all about a blanket policy. It feels more fair, and it also sets a standard boundary both for you and your clients. In my first appointment and in my paperwork, I let clients know that I am not available for on call. If you take insurance, you may not have the leeway to have that boundary, but definitely look at your contract or contracts with different insurance companies to see what their expectation of you is. I also have in my financial agreement and my informed consent that any phone call over 5 minutes is billed at my prorated amount. It's my clinical opinion that if somebody needs to call me consistently between sessions, that they may need more sessions per week or a higher level of care. So I let them know that if I perceive a pattern of that's maybe the clinical recommendation. Sometimes they're like, oh, I didn't need to talk, I just wanted to. In which case I redirect them to friends or family or journaling or other coping skills that we've talked about. Our goal as clinicians is to be not needed by our clients, right? And to allow them to learn the skills and build up the support systems that they need to be able to manage the life up and downs that happen to all of us. Now, that doesn't mean they don't want therapy for personal growth, but maybe they don't need us every time something hard happens. excuse me. Having a set policy for in-between session communication really helps them learn the boundaries. And it lets you know when they may need more clinical intervention. We talk about how to set up some policies and keep your practice sustainable in our Build the Right Practice course, which is in the Abundance Party. That's our foundational course. And it makes sure that you don't end up building yourself basically another agency job, because I don't want that for you. And it really helps you create something that you look forward to every single day. You can find that over at abundanceparty.com. If you have a question for me for Ask Allison, please DM me over on Instagram. I'm abundance_practice_building. Hope you have a great day.